But Dasha Hoppe out of the Patrick School. Baskerville, the answer.
Start to that possession they were hoping for defensively, kind of giving that one away.
Baskerville on the back door. Ball fake over Raven Farley. With six on the timer. Bristow, tough two. Could not hit. Baskerville.
Actually,
it's the mirror.
In that situation in the half court.
Fury got it to go. That snaps
it. And Hoppe and Alston Arn and starring for this team in a season or two.
Williams flips it up and spins in.
With a whole half to go, but this is a big possession.
For St. John's, today was about handling business. They've done that thus far. Bristow's off, gets it back, and one for the freshman. Geary with the spin and the left hand. Some versatility from the sophomore.
Get over.
Providence with five. Williams got a step and puts it in.
Here really early before any of her other teammates were putting up shots and putting in that extra work you love to see players get. And
the answer from
Geary.
Marquette
10 and 4, Butler 9 and 4.
Corner three for Spiewak. Her second ball fake. Spiewak, the sophomore, a sharp shooter, leading the way with eight
second
points.
Half.
10 on the shot clock. Williams, crossover, fake, fader, got it! Extra opportunity though. Webb from distance. Kayla Webb!
Those extra possessions, and now you're starting to see the role players get involved offensively.
Urlette Scott wide open.
To have a chance to pull this off.
Baskerville back door, and one! She'll go to the line to tie the game. 4.6 left. St. John's looking to avoid the upset. Alston for the win, denied by Scott. Divine Providence. The Friars knock off the Red Storm. The Providence Friars were down by 16, but they never gave up, and they get rewarded for it. Urlette Scott with the game-winning three-point play, and the sophomore joining us now. Urlette, what are you thinking on the final play offensively where you put up that shot as you get fouled?
Coach said to never stop fighting, and I just tried to make a play with really nothing. So credit to my teammates. They got me the ball, and yeah, I'm so happy.
We've watched so many games, like you, I'm sure you watched so many games. Was it just going through your head, hey, put up the shot?
Yeah. Being from New York, I always looked up to St. John's and everything, so just being them was really good. Yeah, just credit to my teammates, they helped me through everything.
What a fight. I mean, you guys never gave up in this game. St. John's had a big lead at the half, late in the third quarter as well. What was the key to keep persevering in this game?
Just being down 16, we had in our minds, like, cut it down to 8. Being down 8, cut it down to 4. And when we was down 4, we said we got to take the lead. So just having little, winning little minutes, like 2-minute halves, not like, you know, media. So just winning little games made us win today.
And with how important Mary Baskerville's been for you guys this year, she deals with foul trouble the whole game. So many players like you stepped up. I mean, what does that say about this team?
It just says that we have a lot of depth and we could go against the best on any day.
For this team, though, to be 1-12 in Big East play, could have been easy to give up. Why hasn't this team given up?
We just keep fighting. We know that our record doesn't define us, and we're just going to keep fighting to the end. So if this is the game we had to come up against, then we just had to do it.
I think you should wear these pink threads every night.
I think so, too. These are good luck.
And you were the hero today. Urlette, congratulations
Thank
on an amazing
so
win.
Thank you.
We'll take